When we implant electrodes into brains for therapeutic reasons, all of a sudden we may be stimulating regions of a brain, and that means we're controlling regions of the brain. That raises some ethical concerns. If I can just parse this a little bit, so let me just say what neuroengineering is. It's really the confluence of three domains. It's the confluence of neuroscience, device technology, and computing. Those three together form this sort of special neuroengineering domain. With that comes some ethical issues. And in the sciences, we're going to benefit from a partnership with ethicists and philosophers.
So scientists are trained to do science. And it's not as if they can't talk about values questions. I find generally they're very interested, but they don't feel trained to talk about it. So when we talked to the scientists and engineers in the center, they thought it was really important to do something about these issues, but they didn't feel prepared to do it themselves. There have been questions about, or interest anyway, in doing deep brain stimulators for depression. But now let's say it's on a closed loop, so anytime your levels, neurotransmitter levels or electrical activity levels, go down below a certain level, it automatically boosts you back up. That might be good, but on the other hand, something bad could happen in your life. Your mother dies. Of course you should feel poorly. You would expect that. But then if your levels go down and your machine automatically boosts you back up, right, what would the internal feeling be like?
Just having the graduate students and Sara present in our space and asking us questions raises our consciousness, our neural systems, to be thinking a little more about the ethical implications of what we do.
I do a lot of work in disability studies as well, another interdisciplinary program on campus. And one of the worries from disability studies is we have a lot of investment in these technologies that are intended to help people with disabilities. But some people with disabilities may not actually want the benefit that's intended for them, or they may not see it as a benefit. In some centers for neural engineering, they're working on exoskeletons that would allow a person who would otherwise be using a wheelchair to stand up and move, right, with this sort of robotic structure around their legs. But some people with disabilities would say, I'm not really interested in standing up. I'm fine using a wheelchair, right? If there's a problem, it's that not enough places are accessible and we need to work on that.
Sara gives a really fantastic lecture on what the area of philosophy can do and cannot do. And it's actually interesting what it doesn't do. It doesn't apply rules. It's not law, it's not legal judgment. It doesn't issue a right and wrong. It issues a question of not what could be done, but what should be done. And that could-should thinking is pretty unique to philosophy, and it's something that science should embrace more and more.